Welcome back to Fast Forward, brought to you by Authentics. Our world is becoming more and more digitally dependent every day, so it's important to protect ourselves and our businesses against any potential threats on and offline, as identity fraud is becoming more pervasive than people realize. Joining us now is Carrie Colajay, CEO of Authentics. Carrie, great to have you with us on the show. I do want to understand just how big of a deal is identity fraud and what exactly is driving this issue.
Most people do not understand the magnitude of identity fraud. Globally, identity fraud has actually created $42 billion in losses in the last year. And 33% of Americans have had their identity stolen. Since the pandemic, and as you were talking about in your previous segment, there's been a 300% growth in fraud, and 1 in 10 Americans have had their identity stolen. So as the world has become more digitally dependent, the opportunities for fraudsters have multiplied. And what that means and why that matters for all of us is each time you have a digital interaction, you leave a small little piece of personal information about yourself. You know, whether it's you're logging on to Spotify to listen to your favorite music, or you're shopping online and you enter your credit card information. And each of these digital interactions leaves a little breadcrumb. And to you and to me, these breadcrumbs may seem fragmented or unorganized, but without the proper protection in place, it actually opens up the doors for the fraudsters to follow the trail of information, assembling in them in ways that allow them to actually impersonate you.
And because more and more of our information and our data becomes available, how is identity verification going to evolve when it comes to protecting our personal data?
I think previously, and in order for people to verify who they are, it used to require a face-to-face interaction. And in some countries, this is absolutely still the case. Identity proofing at its core is sharing your passport or your driver's license, a social security number, or your birth certificate. But as we look towards the future, identity verification is not only going to become automated, but seamless and secure. And we're starting to catch glimpses of this today. The previous segment where you did a day in the life of yourself and JD actually depicts what the world could look like. If you're an Apple products advocate and you've got an Apple Watch and you've got a MacBook, you've already experienced this magical moment when you approach your MacBook and it automatically signs you in and opens up the door to the internet. And it's done because there's a series of data signals that happen behind the scenes that are making these decisions. And those types of things that become invisible actually require you or me or any consumer to not do anything except to approach the device.
Yeah, and Carrie, to your point, we laid out how these technologies can help create a more seamless experience, but what about inclusivity? What are some of the ways that this tech is creating a more inclusive way of verification?
I mean, this is what's incredibly exciting, I think, to all of us who've been in the industry for years, is it's allowing people to participate in the global economy that never have before and may have previously been shut out. So take, for example, the financial sector. Right now, there's 3.2 billion people who have an ID but don't have a digital trail. There's another billion people who don't have a legal form of identification. For these individuals, opening up a bank account would require, you know, face-to-face verification. And now you can verify any identity from anywhere in the world, enabling these billions of people to participate in the global economy. So technology has opened up the door to tremendous opportunity. You know, I read a stat the other day with a McKinsey study, and they claim that by 2030, that digital identity verification will unlock the equivalent value of 3% to 13% of GDP. So verifying people's identities is an absolute equalizer, and not just for allowing others to get access to the financial sector, but healthcare and education and so much more.
Yeah, Carrie, you know, as you alluded to, when it comes to identity verification, we often think about fingerprints or government issued IDs, yeah, like passports. But what are some of the other layers that should be top of mind? And why do we need these multiple layers of defense?
Well, technology needs to be adaptive so it can seamlessly verify people and individuals and businesses regarding whether it's the context of a transaction or it's real time because it's the level of risk of a transaction. So let me give you an example. Moving money to a friend or buying dinner, versus buying a house or renting a car, they all require some sort of verification about you, whether it's to validate that you have the credentials to log into your PayPal or your Venmo account, or it's asserting whether or not you're financially qualified to afford the loan. Each of these instances require a certain level of assurance. Assurance is security layers to determine that you are who you say you are. So in the Venmo situation, you know, it's sufficient to provide a username and password, but when applying for a loan, you not only need to verify who you are, but you also need to verify where you live, what your job is like, your income levels, can you afford to pay the loan back? So verification in context really requires on the situation and is something that is going to be real-time, adaptable, and quite exciting.
And with that Venmo example, it feels like immediacy is also critical. To that point, what are some ways verification is becoming more immediate when it comes to those kinds of transactions? And why is that real-time verification becoming increasingly important?
Well, if you're anything like me, immediate gratification is important. All of us expect instantaneous results, whether it's you send a text to a friend and you want them to text you back, whether it's settlement of money, you know, hailing an Uber ride. And you know, waiting, whether it's 3 weeks or 3 minutes, is just not sufficient to get an answer back for today's consumers or the future consumers. So it's our position that the importance along preventing fraud, it can't be at the detriment of immediacy and real-time transactions. So in this new digital world, not only do you need to be compliant with personal information and transactions, but you need to balance security and safety and experience.
Carrie, you laid out some examples, but what's maybe the number one or two things that need to be done to stop this $42 billion issue of identity fraud?
Yeah, I mean, fraud is complex and it's continuous and it evolves with every countermeasure. And one of the most important things is that technology is adaptive for businesses to protect fraud and to protect their consumers while ensuring that transactions are seamless. You know, to verify in identities, you need the right technology in place to support this contactless and digital society, as you talked about earlier. And our mission at Authentix is to protect individuals' personal identifiable information and to ensure global businesses can provide safer services for a more secure and inclusive world. You know, you need to do this with real-time verification, and you need to be able to verify the physical and the digital identity so that companies and their customers can connect. And look, identity is core to everything that we do. It is actually the key that unlocks access and opportunities for individuals and businesses. And the most important thing is that we become aware and we continue to adapt.
And Carrie, thank you for helping to bring us that awareness. We appreciate your time today. That's Carrie Colajay, CEO of Authentix. Thanks again. To learn more about how Authentix can help your business verify digital customer information accurately, securely, and efficiently, visit Authentix.com. I want to bring back in JD, because JD, that's it for this edition of Fast Forward, sponsored by Authentix. We will be back next week with a whole new episode you do not want to miss.
Thanks a lot, Nora. It's a great show today, my friend. And stick with us. More Cheddar is up next.